Now today's lecture on motor system. Now topic is motor area. The main function of the motor nervous system is to provide purposeful, precise, skilled movement. And for that, there is planning and the programming of voluntary movement, first thing. Second thing, initiation or execution of voluntary movement. Third, control of the fine skill movement. So all 4 points, planning, programming, initiation and control, they are responsible for precise, skilled, purposeful movement. To perform this function, various structure involved in the nervous system which work, cooperate and coordinate with one another to achieve this precise skill movement. So this is a skill movement this lady is performing. Now she is writing something in the book notebook. Here you will find there is a precise movement, a skill movement of the fingers and the hand. On the other hand, she is performing some number in tele machine. So here you will find this movement is purposeful and skilled and precise. Now in the slide that you will find somatotopic organization of the motor cortex, and this is very similar to the sensory system. But here you will find a slight variation. The thumb representation is too much, and then vocalization part. Otherwise, it is just like the sensory system representation. Now, M indicate medial surface, medial part of the cerebral hemisphere. Suppose this is the right hemisphere, and this is the lateral part. Medially, you will find the representation of the toes and the knees and ankles. Superior, you will find shoulder and wrist and hand. Laterally, you will find superolaterally hand and big toe. And face representation. Mind it, face representation has always bilateral representation. While other parts, they have unilateral representation. So we must learn in this diagram, the central circles divide the parietal lobe and separate the parietal lobe and frontal lobe. So the posterior frontal lobe, the motor area is situated and it is labeled as primary motor cortex area number 4, Brodmann area number 4. In front of that you will find supplementary area and motor area, premotor area and supplementary area, that is Brodmann number 6. Behind the center circles, we will find the somatosensory area, primary, that is 3, 1, 2 and associate area 5 and 7. So we are concerned with the 3, 1, 2 because 40% of the fibers which is descended down to the anterior motor neuron is from this area, primary somatic sensory area. So it gives after perceive the sensations, it is sent to the premotor area, supplementary area, then into the motor area. So ultimately, corticospinal tract contains 40%, 30% and 30% fibers and they form corticospinal. So it's very clear here, 312 primary somatic area, 57 is a somatic associated area, central circle which divide these two areas means motor area in front of the central circles, the supplementary area and premotor areas. Now this representation in the motor area is inverted homunculus. First thing. Second thing, according to the skill movement, representation occurred in motor cortex. Third thing, that the plasticity map of the motor cortex is not immutable as we thought previously, but now it is very clear it can change with experiences. And this change observed minimally at 1 week time or maximally up to 4 weeks time. So these changes are detectable in the areas. To perform the motor function, so there are many structures are involved and we have to learn these points gradually. One is the motor cortex, motor thalamus, basal ganglion, brain stem centers, motor tracts, anterior greyhound, and motor unit. So the motor cortex or areas, motor areas, will find important role of the center sulcus, post-center gyrus, and the pre-center gyrus. Primary motor area in the precentral gyrus, and few centimeter from this you will find supplementary areas, and superiorly and inferiorly you will find premotor areas. There are specialized areas, no doubt, and you must remember Broca's area 44 and 45, frontal eye field area 8, head rotation area and area for hand discus. Broca's area known as motor speech programming area. And this area determines the dominant hemisphere. If you are right-handed, then in the left hemisphere you will find Broca's area 44 and 45. And this area determines the dominancy of the hemisphere. So it's important. Do not forget. Frontal eye field area is responsible for conjugated voluntary eye movement. This is again very important. And this is just above the 44 and 45. Head rotation area is just above the frontal eye field area. An area of the hand skill is present in front of the areas for hand in the motor area, motor primary motor cortex. So lesion of this area causes motor apraxia. There is no skill movement in the hand. So whatever the way the anterior motor neuron they receives the sensations, we must know between the cerebral cortex and anterior alpha motor neuron what are the things which may involve. So information from the motor cortex goes to the basal ganglion and again to the cortex. In between basal ganglion to the cortex, you will find VL, ventrolateral and ventro-anterior nuclei. Which conduct the information back to the motor cortex and responsible for programmed movement action. So basal ganglion is for the posture movements and this is responsible for programming. So precision is only by the circuit, which involve amplitude, direction, speed, force of movement. So the motor pathways are the two pathways, two descending motor pathways, either motor cortex, basal ganglion, thalamus, and then cerebral cortex. This is one route, another directly to the anterior motor neuron. Third, through the interneuron, it goes to the alpha motor neurons. And third, other areas of this Other than this, there are areas which relay into the anterior motor neuron. So whatever the way commanda reaches to the alpha motor neuron, and this is the final common. So this is the medial midline and extrapyramidal tract. You will find tectospinal, vestibulospinal, reticulospinal, olivospinal, rubrospinal, and the medial longitudinal fasciculus also involved, also formed the extrapyramidal tract. That is in the face label. So tectospinal, these are the spinals, means origin is from tectum, tecto, spinal, vestibuli, nuclei, or and spinal. Similarly over here. So once the descending tracts are there, descending pathways are of two types, lateral system and medial system. And it is indicated by this location in the descending location in white column of spinal cord. So lateral system, as the name indicates, descended in the lateral or lateral white column. Lateral white fasciculus is responsible for lateral system. So the name denotes only because of its position in the spinal cord. So in general, cerebral cortex, internal capsule, again brain stem, they form pyramid in the lower medulla, crosses over takes place directly or indirectly. They relay into the alpha motor neuron and the limbs. 80% of the fibers of the corticospinal tract of the lateral system originate from neuron of layer 5 of cerebral cortex. Then they passes through the posterior limb of internal capsule. They may be monosynaptic relay to the alpha motor neuron or polysynaptic relay to the alpha motor neuron via the interneurons. Another tract which accompany the corticospinal tract and they form the lateral descending system is the corticobulbar tract. Corticobulbar tract arises from the cerebral cortex, passes through the genu of internal capsule. Genu is a junction of the anterior and the posterior limb of the internal capsule. Then they relay into the motor nuclei of 5th, 7th and 12th ganglion nerve. And the respective muscles they get terminate into respected muscles. So we will learn later on the alpha motor neuron, this one, destination in the muscle may be inhibited by the Renshaw cells or may be connected by the propriospinal interneurons or directly to the corticospinal tract. The Renshaw cells may be activated by the segmental input, supraspinal input, or branch from the motor neuron, alpha motor neuron. This is inhibitory in nature and it inhibits the alpha motor neuron. So connection between the basal ganglia and the primary cortex is shown by this picture. Cortex, then basal ganglion, via the thalamus, it again connect to the cortex. So the planning, programming is done for execution of the movement is done by the basal. This picture shows where the motor cortex is situated and from how many contribution of the fibers It passes through the internal capsule, then relay into the cranial motor neurons, nuclei, and then passes through the pyramid, after forming the pyramid, crosses and to the alpha motor neurons. So this point is very clear. All the sensory sensation comes to the spinal cord, to the dorsal root. All the motor sensations, they conveyed by the alpha motor neuron to the respective muscle. Now again, you will find this is the basal ganglion part, thalamus. This is hair shaped is the basal ganglion part, which forms the internal capsule. The connection between the cerebral cortex and the cerebellum is important for the posture. Cortex, pontine nuclei in the pons, then through the middle cerebral peduncle, it goes to the cerebellar cortex, dentate nucleus, then thalamus, again to the cortex. So after these connections and where they originate, where they relay, now the main point which we have to cover is that there are three subareas: primary motor cortex number 4, M1. Primary motor cortex lies in the first convolution anterior to the central sulcus. Broadband areas 4 is assigned to this area. It is again divided into alpha, gamma, eta and 4S. 4S is inhibitory or gives inhibition of the stretch reflexes. Area number 4 is the area, primary motor cortex, where bad cells are found, and they are also known as pyramidal cells. They are present in the fifth layer of the cerebral cortex. They are very large in size. Premotor areas anterior to the primary motor cortex received 40% of the sensations from somatosensory cortex, send their impulses in turn to the motor cortex, the spinal cord and brainstem. What is the main function of this area? Prepare to move. Planning and prepared. Second thing, this control the movement of proximal limb muscles. Proximal muscles are controlled by this. Supplementary area number 6. This representation is bilateral. It extends few centimeter to the superior frontal cortex. So the corticospinal tract may be crossed, uncrossed, direct or indirect, originate from basals or pyramidal neurons, large nuclei, which is present in the Brodmann areas 4 M1. So whether it is crossed, uncrossed, whether they are crossed, then 80% of the fibers, they form the pyramid in the lower medulla. But we must know how to describe the motor sensory or sensory pathway. First thing, you must know origin of the fibers. First thing, where the nuclei are present or receptor in the sensory system, whether they are crossed or uncrossed is an important point. Where they crossed, level of crossing is again important to determine the lesion and response, thickness of the fibers, insertion of the fibers or termination of the fibers. Thanking you and subscribe for the next lecture. Thanking you.